Hey everybody, I'm Dave Lewick, the Trapper Guy. I'm a nuisance wildlife trapper in the Tampa Bay area of Florida, and today I'm going to be talking about, should you save a baby squirrel? Now, usually what happens is you're walking along, you see a baby squirrel on the ground, it looks really helpless and cute, and you want to pick it up and help it. And let's face it, all things are cute when they're babies. Well, maybe not all things. Now you have this little baby squirrel, and the first thing you need to think to yourself, does this squirrel actually need help? Baby squirrels fall out of trees all the time. It doesn't mean they're abandoned. You found that baby squirrel, you're looking around, you can't see a mom anywhere. She may be off doing something else and doesn't know the baby's on the ground yet. Or maybe she can't get the baby squirrel back up in the tree and she's just taking care of that squirrel on the ground. You may not see her now because she's hiding because there's a big scary human and she's thinking of self-preservation and staying hidden. Now the best thing for any baby animal is to be raised by their mother. So the best thing to do with that squirrel is just to put it back on the ground where you saw it. You don't have to worry that you touched it. That's an old wives' tale. The mother will still come to it no matter if you've touched it or handled that squirrel. So set it down on the ground, be brave and walk away. Don't just go 30 foot away and sit in a lawn chair and wait for mom to come down because she probably won't do it while you're there. Or even check on it every 5 minutes. Just put it down on this ground and just walk away. Now what if you know this is an orphan squirrel? Maybe you saw the mom get hit by the car or something else horrible happened to her. Now what are you gonna do with this baby squirrel? Do you already know where a rescue or rehabilitator is? They're actually not that easy to find. Most of them are individuals and they don't have websites or they're not listed in anywhere, so they're very hard to find. And they're also volunteers, so they usually don't have somebody working the phone, so if they're on vacation, you're not even gonna know that. So now you have this baby squirrel and you're desperate, and you end up giving it to somebody who may not really know how to take care of it very well, or you decide to take care of it yourself if you do have the time, and maybe you get some bad information on how to take care of it on the internet, and then this baby squirrel dies, and unfortunately you'll have to probably put it in a shoebox and bury it in the backyard. So now you're probably asking, what's the alternative? I can't find a rescue, or this is too much trouble to take care of. Guess what? Even if that is an orphan baby squirrel, you can still put it back on the ground. It's wildlife. There is a thing called the food chain out there. There may be a mama hawk nearby that needs to feed her babies. Well, they're predators, and that's a prime food source. It sounds horrible, but that's the way nature works. There's other animals out there, like coyotes or even snakes, and that's their main food source. So I get a ton of calls about coyotes taking cats and things like that in neighborhood, or dogs off leashes. And I have to wonder, if there wasn't people around here just picking up hundreds of baby squirrels, how much food would those coyotes be getting where they wouldn't have to go after people's pets? So if you see a baby squirrel on the ground and you don't know the situation or what to do next, go ahead and just let nature take its course and leave it on the ground. Try to check your emotions or even try to channel the Trapper Guy's inner toughness.
I don't care what I said in the video, I'm taking you to a rescue.